Yes, welcome back to the show. Those who have just joined us, we are with Honorable Lucy Nankavire, the government chief whip, telling us her life experience. And now, Ruth, we go into work. We finished educating.
Yes.
Education.
Yes.
We've had children, but you'll tell us more of them. And then tell us now what? We go into the working field.
Of course, after campus.
Mm-hmm.
That was in 1992-93. There was a law that was enacted in NRC, and I think you were part of it, establishing women councils and youth councils throughout the country.
Yes, we did.
I picked the idea.
Mm-hmm.
I rushed to Chiboga at my village.
Mm-hmm.
I told my mother, I want to be a chairperson of the women. Said, what, you?
You are not a woman. You
know, I didn't have
by our culture, you are not a woman, you are a girl.
I told mom that what you have to do, just lend me that gomes of yours and teach me how to tie the gomes, and I will go and talk to the women.
And there you went.
I joined the women councils up to the district level, going through unopposed. At the district level, and I think that is when the CA
was coming
1994.
Okay, yes.
I have gone through these sub-counties and I'm now known.
Now who could
as Sentamu's daughter. Sentamu is my father's name. I chose to use my father's name because he made it.
What was your father doing? Did you ever know what she was doing?
Was a soldier.
Hey.
In the King African Rifle Army. He rose up to the rank of a sergeant from Uganda.
So
up
you,
to Burma.
So you have that blood. No wonder you ended up Minister of State for defense.
So I am fearless anyway. Whatever work you bring to me, I will say yes, I will do it. So when I joined CA, you had my contributions in the CA. And I was very careful. I was a good listener. People mentored me.
I know I did a lot to mentor you.
Yourself.
Yes.
Winnie Byanyima, we established Forum for Women in Democracy. We used to go through workshops. So
the dialogue.
CA was good. And people used to tell us to be careful about the men who were in the CA.
Why don't you say Honorable used to tell us? I remember I used to hold you like my young children, telling you, dress like this, you be careful, these men are there like hyenas. And
yes,
they, you know.
yes.
Yeah.
And I kept my name.
You did.
You know, I was in danger because I was using my maiden name. Ruth Nankabirwa. You know what that means culturally?
That you are not married.
You are freelance.
You are there.
Yet at that time, I was customarily married.
You were already married.
Yes, with the children.
Okay, yes.
With two
yes.
children.
Mm.
And although we had not gone to church, but we were staying together.
Yes.
So I had to protect that.
Mm.
And I remember we really had a very good time. I didn't have a car at that time. But you remember how we used to go to hike
to
go to Najanakumbi, a wastera,
with the Kazora,
to eat echimere.
Yes,
you know, moving in the same car.
I remember those
you
days
know,
very well.
You remember the chapatis, okay, and the groundnuts.
Yes,
and the matoke. We used to eat a lot.
But we didn't grow fat.
I grew round, and I remember reading myself. In
but
the papers,
that,
that I was the most rounded.
That poor woman is, I think the road took her off.
I don't see her house. Part of her house was taken away by the road construction.
Okay, so now CA, we finish CA, we make our constitution.
In
CA,
we had solidarity. You remember how we used to move to people's constituencies?
Yes,
for the first time, the voters were seeing more than 10 CA delegates. You know, we went to there, Bunyanga, Bunyaruguru, Bunyaruguru.
We used to move as a team
to contribute. That's when fundraising started. So when it came to 1996 elections, now elections for parliament.
You were already known.
I was already known, but
you had made a mark.
The constitution was a baby. Mm. I was the mother to this baby.
So that's what how you were
campaigning. I told people to allow me breastfeed my baby. It worked for
you
me.
You had the right words to campaign.
I had the right words to campaign. Mm. And after that, I won, of course. And I just had my name being announced when the president established his government in 1998, my first assignment.
I think it was 98. Now, I remember.
The Minister of State
when you reached Parliament, that's when the Kazoras made the young...
YPA.
The Young Parliamentarians Association.
Yes.
And you are one of them.
Yes.
And you are, you know...
Yes.
Very, what do I call it?
I fought for the land.
Sharp, outgoing, very brilliant.
You know the Land Act where there was a move to automatically change leasehold
to freehold.
To freehold.
Mm. Didn't we secure that in CA?
That's, no.
Eventually, yes.
Automatically.
Eventually, we had it in...
I opposed it.
Did you oppose it?
Because that automatic, you know, because you acquire lease, after identifying what you are going to do on the land, and they give you 5 years.
Well, what are you talking about? I thought it was like if you already have a lease in town. In fact, we had said in Kampala, when you had a lease, then after the law, the lease turned into a freehold. Instead of going to apply 99 years, then they take away, then you have been there for 99 years, then they say you apply again.
I think that's what I was opposing, because for the village, what used to happen were people who used to get these leases and leave them there. Emisune jiberako.
Oh, actually.
Nayagala to say automatically to freehold. So I found myself in cabinet, first assignment, Minister of State for Luero Triangle to deal with veterans. And at that time, veterans used to demonstrate. They used to go to Nakasero Gate. I said, how will I manage?
Mm.
But as I told you, I always say, well, the appointing authority knows that I will manage. So let me do it. And I feel bad to be defeated. I really feel bad. Whenever you give me an assignment, I want to do it. So I said I'll do it. And I worked.
Actually, I remember one time after, I think it was during your campaign, I don't know what had happened there in Chiboga, and you expressing your toughness, and you said, for me, I'm so tough. You know, my father used to kill a snake with his hip.
Yes.
Whereas other people have to look for a stick to eat a snake.
Tata wange yari nyako nechigere.
Yoyorusi. Hey, tomuza nyira kwa ringa tata we.
So from being a Minister of State for Luero Triangle, I survived the 2 reshuffles there. First reshuffle, the president left me to continue. But we went for elections from 96 to 2001. That is when he appointed me Minister of State for Defense. Now from dealing with veterans to dealing with
the soldiers. You had gained experience to deal with the defense itself.
I am telling you, I developed cold feet. I felt coldness.
Some of us were very excited, like, you know, my cause for gender equality and women's empowerment, we keep fighting that we should not be left to these traditional positions of responsibility.
But not defense. So when at they that said, time,
but
with,
defense,
with
when,
my...
a, when a woman is appointed to defense, that show that, yes,
defense had a lot of challenges. That is the time when we had Joseph Kony in the north. That's when we had some bomb throwing in the city, all those challenges. And I used to listen on radios, Ngabakola Katemba. This is Nankabirwa. Ha, Fande Nankabirwa. because they knew that I had never been trained. Mugu sawa hata gambie mugu pande, you know, doing katemba that maybe I will not be able to, but
to
I
manage.
Want to assure you and I want you to manage, tell you media enjoyed, because I enjoy challenges. I enjoyed the Ministry of Defense, where I served for close to 8 years. Every time government is established, I am put back to defense. And the president said, handle welfare.
Mm.
And I'm happy to note that I worked on the salary for the UPDF.
Mm.
Uniforms, you remember how parliament...
Uniform, I remember that corruption saga.
The
corruption deal where the uniforms were small.
Short, were
and
from
the shoes
China.
Were,
we
what
had,
happened then?
We, then the ghosts.
By then I was the Minister of Ethics and it was
computerization
terrible.
Of the systems to do away with the ghosts.
Mm.
I have a lot to talk about in defense.
Okay.
That did not take away my being a wife and a mother.
You managed.
I even got pregnant when
I
was.
Know you, I know that.
And I used to be on the parade, you know, inspecting parade when the band is, you know. And I'm also having my band, carrying my band, and
really
but what
tough.
I didn't like in defense was to address me as sir. Yes, sir. Then I look at you and then say, madam.
You never changed that one.
So they used to call me sir, madam.
Mm.
Sir, madam.
That one,
sir,
I
madam.
Don't know whether it will ever change.
So in defense, the challenges were enormous. When I was appointed as a Minister of State for Defense, and I want to thank my husband, was working with the Minister of Lands. He sat down himself and told me, Ruth, now that you have been appointed a Minister of Defense, we are not going to have you at home. Let me submit my early retirement so that I will be at home and I will be handling our personal projects. Himself. Ask these men, which man really can offer to retire so that the wife
can excel?
Can excel.
Uh-huh. Challenge them. Tell them.
Who? This man retires and, you know, concentrates on our family.
Your
we had a young, a very young family. You, because you ask me, how do you manage to balance minus this man? I would not manage.
You would not have.
You remember the caucus meetings we used to have? You go back very late, you know? And if you don't have an understanding spouse.
Too late.
Too late.
You know,
so
Lucy, you are talking about a very important point, because I have come to find out that every woman who has been able to succeed and raise to greater heights, besides her, there is a very supportive, caring husband. That's what I have found out.
It is true. You have testimonies. We've given testimonies. This man retired. And we started on our personal projects. I've been a champion of tree growing. It is this man who is always in the forest there. We have planted trees since 2003. Up to now, we are still planting trees as a business.
That's good.
We are doing everything together. And he encourages me. And you will not see me working with him during campaigns, showing him.
No.
I'm married, period.
That's it.
Period. Why do you want to see my husband? He's busy. He's with the children. He's doing business. I see women parading their husbands everywhere, parading.
You know, let me tell you, Nankabirwa, you have risen this issue. I wanted to leave you to talk and finish, but it reminds me of when I was contesting for member of parliament in 19, for, I think it was for CA. I had these three women who were coming. The first time, one came with a husband and stood up and said, and they had told people that me, I'm a rebel, I parted with my husband long ago. So to prove it for them, they came with their husband. They said, this is my husband. And he talked about the husband for about 5 minutes. So when I stood up, I said, you know what? When somebody is given a microphone to tell you about herself, And all she talks about is her husband. You know, she has nothing to tell you about herself. Just ignore and listen to me.
Yes, you know.
And so, then when we went on the second, she went with her, I think, the second polling station where we are campaigning. Now both of them combined. One stood and talked about a husband. Another stood and talked about a husband. And then when I stood up, I said, you people who are listening to me, you women over here, don't you have widows among yourselves? They said yes. Don't you have single mothers? They said yes. Don't you have those who have never married? They said yes. So if all these people are talking about his husband, do they know anything about you who don't have husbands? Just look at me. I'm the one who
really
help
beat
you.
Them.
And it just ended there. They never brought these husbands again.
Yeah.